Alright, yo, what's going on, everybody? It's Spinny back with another Minecraft tutorial video. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to get shaders on Minecraft Windows 10, Xbox One, PS4, Pocket Edition, and I believe we can also get them on the Switch. This is Minecraft Bedrock, all Minecraft Bedrock editions. If you play Java, that's completely different than this. Nevertheless, let's get right into this tutorial. Thank you guys so much for clicking on this video. Any subscriptions or likes are greatly appreciated. If you're interested, I host a Minecraft community world every Wednesday and Sunday. Nevertheless, if you have any questions or any problems throughout this tutorial, let me know in the comments down below. I will respond, but let's get right into it. Beginning with the Xbox One shaders. Now this is what they look like. They look pretty decent for console, but in order to get this, you need to actually have two applications installed on your Xbox. The first one is MC Add-ons Manager right here on the left, and the second one is Microsoft Edge, which automatically comes installed on all Xboxes. So the first thing you want to do is go to the Microsoft Store and you want to type in MC Add-ons Manager just like that, and then you'll see it right here, and it's the one with the little chest on it, and you want to install that app just like that. After doing that, you want to go over to Microsoft Edge, click on it, and let that load up. And once that loads up, you want to go up to the top to the URL search, and you want to type in this big long URL, www.mediafire.com/file/3xd0nz8g9c/console/shaders.mcpack/file. So make sure you pause the video, have it just like I do right there. If you mess it up, it won't work. But once you type that in, it'll take you to this web page right here, this MediaFire download page, and all you want to do is go where it says download. You want to click it. Now it'll actually sometimes open a blank page like this. You just want to go up and close this page and then go back to the console shader MediaFire download just like this. And once you click on that, you'll see on the bottom you'll get a prompt that tells you that you've downloaded it. You want to go and click save as, and now you just want to wait, you want to let it load, and once it loads, it should take you to this thing that says this device and downloads. This is the right place. If it says it right there in the top left, all you want to do is go down and hit save just like that, and then it should say, it says my file already exists, but that's because I already have it downloaded. For you, it should just work. And after you click save, save as, just like that, you can simply close out of everything. It's saved your downloads, and you're good to go into MC Add-ons Manager. So once you open up MC Add-ons Manager, this application is actually really cool, as it allows you to get a lot of custom things like custom skin packs right here. I actually have a custom skin packs video. If you guys are interested in that, you can go check that out, link in the description. But once you have MC Pack Manager open, you want to go up to the top where it says import, just like that. Then once you click import, it'll automatically take you to your downloads page, and you want to find the console shader download. It says console shaders. You literally just downloaded it. For many of you, it might be the only thing there, but you just want to click on that, and then you'll see on the top left, it'll start to say installing pack. So it'll take a little bit of time to install, but once it's done, it'll say importation complete, just like that. Do you want to delete the original source file? Go ahead, sure, hit okay. But the main thing is you want to see resource packs, and you want to see it say console shaders, just like this. Yours should be the same. After you do this, you're good to go. You're good to close MC Add-ons Manager. You can now go open up your own Minecraft. So basically all the work has been done at this point. We just have to activate the resource, the shader pack so far. So once you open up Minecraft to the home screen, you want to click play. I usually just go and create a new world when I importate these shaders. So go to create new world, hit create new world, go through all these settings here. I'm just going to turn it on to creative quickly. I've just turned it on to creative so you can go fly around. But what you want to make sure you do is go down to the left here where it says resource packs. That is important. Go to resource packs. Then you'll see on the right side you see my packs. So you want to go down to my packs. And then you'll click on that, you'll go down, and you'll see console shaders just like that. It should be there for you. You want to click on it and then hit activate just like that. And then you'll go up to your active packs above it, and it should be on the top just like that. Perfect. Amazing. And then that's literally all you have to do. You can now go create the world, open the world up, and you'll notice that when you load in, you'll actually have the shaders activated. Again, for console, they're pretty cool. The leaves are moving, the water's different, it's got a little different textures. Cool sky barriers, honestly. So yeah, overall, a decent pack for console. Again, on console, you're going to be limited, so much better than nothing anyway. So yeah, if you ever want to deactivate the shaders, you just want to go back to your active resource packs, and you just want to click on it and hit deactivate, and then it'll turn off and go back to the original ones. Nevertheless, that's the Xbox One. Let's move on to the PS4. Okay, so the first thing I have to preface about the PS4 shaders is that there's absolutely no way to get shaders in solo Minecraft on PS4. What this means is there's no MC Add-ons Manager like there is on Xbox One. On PS4, you have no way of installing shaders on your own. So what you actually have to do is join another person's world who has the correct shaders on. I'm sorry, this is a big inconvenience, but it is literally the only way to do it on PS4. As if you're on PS4, I'm sorry, you can't have nice things, unfortunately. This is just the way Sony is. They're such a pain. But nevertheless, I'll show you guys how to host some worlds with the correct shaders right now. Basically what I mean, you have to have a friend with the shaders on, and then you have to join the world, and then you have to download the shaders through that. And that's the only way to do it, I'm sorry, but I'll show you guys how to do this starting with the computer. So if you want to host a world for PS4 players to play from PC, what you want to do is go onto your computer, go into the description of this video, and click on the PS4 shaders link, and it'll take you to this webpage download right here that says console shaders. All you have to do is go right here and click download, and that will begin the download. A little pop-up will happen here. You can just simply close out of that, but you want to look on the bottom left of your screen and you'll see the download happening. It might take a couple minutes, but nevertheless it should be there. Once it's done downloading, literally all you have to do is simply click on it just like this, and it will automatically launch Minecraft Bedrock on your PC. Click open file profile right there on the bottom left of your screen. It'll open up Minecraft, and what you'll notice is as the game loads up, you'll look towards the top of your screen and it'll say import started. That's perfect, and it'll take a little bit of time, and then after a little bit of time, it'll say successfully imported. Mine says failed, that's because I already have it imported. It'll say successfully imported console shaders. Then what you want to do is simply go and click create a new world. You want to make a new world, and what you want to do is make sure you're on the left side of your screen here. You want to go down to where it says resource packs. You want to click that. After doing that, you'll see on the right side of your screen it says My Packs, and when you click on that, you'll see console shaders right there. All you have to do is click console shaders, and then you want to go right here and click activate, and that'll simply put on the shaders. That's literally all you have to do. Next, you want to go to where it says multiplayer, and you want to make sure you have multiplayer game on. You can have it on invite only, friends only, whatever you want. Nevertheless, you're going to want to be able to invite people to this world. So once again, check the shaders. You're all good. You should be ready to create the world after doing these steps. And once the world loads up, you'll see that you do in fact have these console shaders on. Again, these are the same ones as the Xbox One, but nevertheless, the world will be open. Then what you want to do is go on your PS4 or have your friend go on their PS4 and come join your PC. You can go to your friends tab right there and the world should be there if you have it on open. Nevertheless, just have them simply join. While they're joining, get to say, do you want to download the skin pack? Click OK. You download it, and then once you join the world on PS4, you will actually have the shaders. As you can see right here, again, the PC has to be hosting. The shaders don't stick around on PS4 after you leave the game. You only have them while you're in the game. It's the only way to make it work. I'm sorry, you have to join somebody else who has the shaders pre-on. So this could be on PC, somebody on Xbox One with the shaders on, I believe you can join them. And again, when you're joining them on PS4, it'll ask you if you want to download the resource pack. You hit OK, you can join the world, and you will be able to see the shaders though if you're on PS4. So again, it's like the only way to make it work on PS4. It's better than nothing, I guess. But yeah, if your friends play on PS4, if you want to host a realm on PC and keep the shaders on, I believe this should all work. I know these PS4 shaders might sound kind of useless, but at the end of the day, it's literally the only way to do it on this console. And I guess if you have a couple friends who want to join you on PS4 and you're on like Xbox One or PC and you have the ability to host with these shaders on, it's kind of a cool little thing you can do. Anyways, let's move on to Windows 10 Edition. So, to get shaders on your PC, on your Windows 10 Bedrock Edition, what you have to do is go into the description of this video and click on the link that says PC Windows 10 Edition Shaders. Once you get here, it's extremely easy to do. All you have to do is simply click the download button, close out of this little pop-up that happens here, and then in the bottom left of your screen, you'll see that the shaders will start downloading, just like this. All you want to do is simply wait for them to get done and then click on open file, and it will automatically open up your Minecraft Bedrock Edition. Once you get in the game, you'll look to the top and you'll see it says import started. That is perfect. You want to give it some time, and then eventually it'll say that it successfully installed the fog pack. Then what you want to do is go create a new world just like this, and during creation you want to go to the bottom left here where it says resource packs. Then you want to go over to where it says my packs on the right side of the screen, and you'll see the fog pack right there. All you have to do is simply click on the fog pack, and you'll see that it says activate below it. Click activate, and then you'll see it goes up to your active packs, just like that. Now this pack actually comes with a behavior pack as well, so if you go down below resource packs on the left here, you go to my packs, and you'll see the dig pack is also right there. You want to click on it, and you want to hit activate, just like that. This will turn off achievements, so you don't have to turn this on, but if you want to, go for it, and it should work. So after you have both those packs activated, all you have to do is simply go ahead and create the world. Now once you load into the world, you might be like, bruh, what is this? This is like a full-on texture pack. I know this might not be the most beautiful thing ever, but for those of you who don't know, like Minecraft Bedrock on PC literally had an update that like changed everything. It broke a lot of shader packs, so currently a lot of them are broke, but this is like the only one I could find that works currently. So if there's a new one that comes out that works, I'll update the description. If you don't like the way the textures look in this, you can go back and deactivate that behavior pack that we put on, but you want to keep the resource pack on, and that will change it up a little bit. But nevertheless, the grass still kind of looks like plastics. I'm sorry, this is what we're stuck with on Windows 10 Edition. Again, I'll update that description if new things come out. If you guys have to inform me if I'm missing something here, let me know. I'll fix the description. Keep checking it. It'll stay up to date with everything. But nevertheless, yes, that's how you get shaders on PC Edition so far. Also, the Xbox One shaders, as shown earlier in this video, also work on PC, so those can work as well if you want to use those instead. Let's move on to the Pocket Edition shaders. So for Minecraft Pocket Edition shaders, it's very easy. All you want to do is go into the description of this video where it says Pocket Edition shaders, and you want to click that link, and it'll actually take you to this webpage right here on mcpedal.com. Once you get to this webpage, all you want to do is scroll down like I'm doing in this video until you see this download button right here where it says download ESBE_2G. You just want to click that, and then all of a sudden it'll take you to this, and it says open in Minecraft right there. All you want to do is click open in Minecraft. It'll open up your Minecraft automatically, and towards the top of your screen you'll see it says import started. All you want to do is wait for this import to get done. Mine says failed, but yours should say work. Mine just failed because it's a duplicate. I already have it imported. Nevertheless, yours should say successfully imported. Then all you want to do is go in to create a new world, and what's important is you want to go to the left side here where it says resource packs. Make sure you have that selected. Go over to My Packs, and you'll see it right there, the ESBE shaders. You want to click on it, and you just want to hit activate just like that, and it'll go up to your top. And again, you'll see it on the top here, the ESBE shaders activated on the top. It's perfect. You're good to go. Open up your Minecraft world, and you'll see when you start it, you'll have all the shaders installed. Minecraft Pocket Edition shaders are really nice. If you guys have more suggestions in the comments or anything for shaders, I'll keep updating the description with new things. But this is a really nice shader that I found, and I think just the water, the sky barrier, just everything looks so good. But anyways, yeah, enjoy the shaders, everyone, and if you have any problems or questions, make sure to leave them down in the comments down below. I will answer them, but yeah, good stuff. So thank you all so much for watching this video. I hope I helped you guys get some shaders. I hope I made your experience a little bit better with Minecraft. Again, on some consoles we're limited, but I did my best to try and do some research to figure out what works and what doesn't. If you guys have suggestions in the comments down below, if I'm doing something wrong, let me know. I will happily update the description. If there's a better pack out there, I'll put it in there. Again, it's basically the same process for all consoles. You just click download, you click open file, and there you go. It'll literally install itself. You just have to go to resource packs, click on it, hit activate. It's that easy. Thank you all so much again. It's been Smitty. Enjoy them, and until the next video, y'all, have a great rest of your day. I'll talk to you guys later. Peace out.